Hello guys, how are you doing? Today let's go to page 10. Listening, form completion. Before you listen, look at the words and numbers. Are there any names of letters or numbers that you don't know how to say in English? I'm sure that all of you know the letters and numbers in English. Okay, listening, form completion, part 1. In the IELTS test, you are often asked to complete part of a form by writing a number or a name which is spelled for you. Listen to 8 speakers and decide if each name or number is written correctly or incorrectly. Let's listen.
Complete IELTS, Bands 4 to 5, by Guy Brookhart and Vanessa Jakeman. Published by Cambridge University Press. This recording is copyright. CD 1. Track 1. Unit 1. Listening. Exercise 1. 1.
R-O-M-N-E-Y.
2.
C-A-E-R-N-S.
3.
B-R-A-G-G.
4.
J-I-C-K-E-L-L.
5.
Fawcett. That's F-A-W-C-E-T-T.
6.
It costs 50 cents.
7.
My telephone number is 0726-05791.
8.
30 Lovers Road. That's L-O-V-E-R-S.
1 is correct. 2, incorrect. 3, correct. 4, incorrect. 5, correct. 6, incorrect. 7 is correct and 8 is incorrect. Now let me tell you a couple of tips. Tip 1. Many students have difficulty hearing the difference between 50 and 15, especially as the final N of 15 is lightly pronounced and hard to hear. Well, the difference is in the stress and the short and long E. For example, 50, the stress is on the first syllable. And 15, the stress is on the second syllable, teen. So in numbers 13 to 19, the stress is on teen. But in numbers 30 to 90, the stress is on the first syllable, 30, 40. Tip 2, you can read two similar letters as, for example, LL or double L. And tip 3, don't forget to learn ordinal numbers like first, second, third, fourth, and so on. Alright, now let's go to exercise 2. Work in pairs. Spell out these names and read these numbers to each other. Then listen to check your answers. Let's listen and check the answers.
Track 2. Unit 1. Listening. Exercise 2. 1.
B-R-A-C-K-E-N.
2.
G-O-W-E-R.
3.
J-E-R-E-M-Y.
4.
P-O-L-L-A-R-D.
5. V-E-R-N-O-N.
6.
17.
7. O-1-9-5-0-6-7-4-2-3-6. 8.
31st.
If you have a partner, you can spell your names, addresses, telephone numbers and email addresses to each other. Before doing exercise 3, you may close your books, please. Now, in your notebooks, list as many different types of holiday accommodation as you can, like hotels, resorts, hostels. You have 3 minutes to do this. You may pause the video and start now. Okay, now tell me one advantage and one disadvantage of staying in a hotel when on holiday. You should write as many ideas as possible in your notebooks. After doing this, you should try to talk about the advantages and disadvantages of staying in a hotel for a couple of minutes. Or you can say which one you prefer, a hotel or an apartment, and why. Now try to do it in 2 minutes. You may pause the video now and start. Okay, now open your books to page 10, exercise 3. Work in small groups. You are going to hear a man phoning to ask about a holiday apartment. Before you listen, answer these questions. Question 1. What are the advantages and disadvantages of staying in an apartment when you're on holiday? And question 2. What sort of holiday accommodation do you prefer? You can write the answers in the comment section below. Okay, now let's go to exercise 4. Here are some tips. In the IELTS exam, you hear each part once only. So it's important to know what to expect before listening and to use the preparation time for each section well. Form completion tasks are typically listening part 1 tasks. They test students' ability to listen for specific details. It's important to know what details you should listen for beforehand. Hence, this exercise where you analyze as far as you can what type of information is required for each gap. Some words in a form may be spelled out and you have to write them down. As for work in pairs, look at the form below. 1. In which gaps do you think you will have to A. write a number only, okay, the answer is gap 3, 4, and 6. B. understand words which are spelled out. The answer is 1 and 2. C. Write a number and a word. The answer is 5. Question 2. What sort of information do you need for the other gaps? Okay, look at gap 7. Something in the apartment. Gap 8, something you can see from the apartment. Gap 9, something about the air conditioning. And gap 10, something for a car. Okay, exercise 5. Look at the instructions. Must you write 2 words or should you sometimes write 1 word? Uh-huh, sometimes one. Must you write either words or a number, or can you write words and a number? The answer is words and a number. What happens if you write three words? The answer will be wrong. Okay, exercise 5. Now listen and complete the form. Write no more than two words and or a number for each answer. Let's listen.
Track 3. Unit 1. Listening. Exercise 5.
Dubai Palm Apartments. Amanda speaking. How can I help you?
Oh, hi, Amanda. I'm ringing to inquire about a holiday apartment for the month after next.
Okay, no problem. Let me get your details first, then I'll tell you what we've got. Is that all right?
Fine, go ahead.
Okay. Can I have your name first, please?
Yes, it's Leo Blücher. That's L-E-O, that's my first name, and my surname is B-L-U-C-H-E-R.
Okay, I've got that. Where are you from, just out of interest, Leo?
I'm Austrian.
Right, okay. And what's your address?
It's number 37, Blumengasse, in Vienna.
Right. Could you just spell Blumengasse for me, please, Leo? My German's not too good.
Sure. It's B-L-U-M-E-N-G-A-S-S-E.
Great, thanks. And what's the weather like in Vienna at the moment?
It's pretty grey and rainy, I'm afraid. Hope it's better in Dubai.
Yes, it's lovely at the moment. Sunny and warm, but not too hot. Now, can you give me your phone number?
Yes, it's 4312-11057.
Great. So, you're looking for a holiday apartment, Leo. How many people is it for? Just yourself?
No, there'll be four of us, two adults and two children.
Fine. And when would you like it from?
Ideally from the 1st of January.
January the 1st. Okay. I'll have a look and see what we've got. How long would you like to stay?
Well, it depends a little bit on the price, but I think that about 9 days would be perfect.
Fine. And talking of prices, what would be your maximum, do you think?
Well, I've looked on the internet, but I don't know if I'm being realistic if I say 200 euros per day. Things seem to range from 150 to well over 400.
Well, it depends where, of course, but I think we could probably find something for you at that price.
Great. There are various other things, though. Our children are quite small, and we don't want to take them to restaurants all the time. So one thing we'd really appreciate is a fully equipped kitchen, so we can do some cooking.
Yes, I completely understand. Do you have any other special requirements?
Yes, we live in the city centre, hundreds of miles from the sea, so we'd really like to be able to see it from our apartment.
Okay, I'll note that down. All our apartments come with air conditioning and central heating, by the way.
Oh dear, one thing I don't like is the noise of air conditioning in the background. Can you make sure it's as quiet as possible?
Yes, I'll look into that. Anything else?
Yes, just one more thing. We'd like to hire a car while we're in Dubai, so we'll need to have a parking space, I think. We don't want to have to walk a long way from the car to the apartment.
I think you're quite right. I'll look into all these things and make a list of possible apartments. Do you have an email address so I can send them to you?
All right, you can look at the recording script to make sure your answers are correct. Let's check the answers. Number one, how do you spell that? L-E-O-B-L-U-C-H-E-R. Number two, B-L-U-M-E-N-G-A-S-S-E. Number three, 4312-11057. Number four, first. Number five, 9 days. Number six, 200. Number seven, kitchen. Number eight, beach or the beach. Number nine, quiet. Number 10, parking space or parking or space. All of them are correct. Now let's go through the exam advice. Form completion. Before you listen, think what information you need for each gap. Do not write more words than the instructions tell you to. And write words or numbers you hear. All right, now let's go to exercise 6, work in pairs. Take turns to talk about a place you have stayed at. Say why you stayed there, who you stayed with, and what you did while you were there. You have a couple of minutes to prepare, and after that try to speak for 1 to 2 minutes. Alright, thank you for watching guys, and please subscribe, like and share it with your friends.